because you hate the light. Atheists say, hey, you Christians, you're just afraid of the darkness. I say you atheists are afraid of the light. You say Christians, we're afraid of the dark, we need a threat. I say you atheists are afraid of the light. You're afraid of the truth. You're afraid of God. That's why you atheists spend so much time reading the Word of God, trying to prove there is no God, but yet you keep coming back. You keep coming back because there's power. There's power in the name of Jesus Christ. That's why people purposely curse Jesus. People don't go around cursing Muhammad. They should. He's a pervert. But yet Jesus is the Word of God made flesh. Jesus is the Word of God made flesh. Everything you need to know is in the man Christ Jesus, the King of Israel. Hallelujah. He's the King of kings and Lord of lords. On his cross it said, King of the Jews.
Get back to America.
Is that all you have? Are you stoned? You don't have a bigger vocabulary than that? Maybe read the Bible and God will help your stoned mind to grow. See, some people, they don't want to grow. They don't want knowledge. They want to stay stupid and stoned and in the hooker's houses. Well, the Word of God says the harlot will lead you to hell. Those of you that have come here for hookers, the Bible says the pathway of the harlot leads to hell. I'm out here to shine the light of the gospel and show you the way out of hell. The Word of God is the light. Thy word is the lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. Blessed be the name of the Lord. There's only one holy book. My book is a good God. That's why it's called the good book to the world. But men love their darkness rather than the light. So that's a question today to ask yourself. Do I love darkness or do I love light? You know, a lot of perverts like 50 Shades of Grey. There is no 50 Shades of Grey. There's black and white. You're saved or you're damned. There's no gray area with God. Fifty Shades of Hellfire. And this is the condemnation, that light is come into the world. But men love their darkness rather than the light. There was no but there. It said and. Not but and. Men love darkness rather than the light. Why? Because their deeds were evil. And everyone that does evil in the light, lest his deeds should be reproved. But he that doeth truth, he that doeth truth, comes to the light, that his deeds may be made manifest that they are wrought in God. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. So there you have it, John chapter 3. Light and darkness. Light and darkness. This is a dark city. Very dark city. But regardless of how low down, dirty, dog, sinful the city is, there are still Christians praying here. Mercy of God. When God tells his street preachers to leave a city, that's when you should be scared. Because when God removes the light, it's fully dark. Darkness. God wants to save you today. God is not willing that any of you perish, but that you all come to repentance. The Word of God declares, repent, for the kingdom of God is at hand. God's kingdom is here. Righteousness, joy, and peace. How many of you have peace? Or do you need a cigarette? Alcohol? Praise of man. Some people have no peace in their life because their God is Instagram. Your God is yourself. You live for the glory of your Instagram praise. Many of you, you gotta take a new photo. You gotta Photoshop it just right. Why? So 100 people will praise you. Is that the meaning of life? Really? Having a great Instagram photo for a bunch of people you don't even know, that don't care about you, that won't come see you in the hospital if you get sick? Let me tell you who loves you, boys and girls. The God of the Bible. The God of the Bible loves you. God of the Bible that heals. Jesus is the healer. He heals broken hearts. If you have a broken heart today, Jesus will heal you. But the greatest healing you need is your soul to be healed, your spirit to be saved. That's more important than why you cry every day. Maybe you cry every day because there's a void in your life that only God can fill. God wants to give you peace and joy in the Holy Spirit.